Because this separation of variables technique for solving differential equations can be kind of hard for kids, I've been trying to do a lot of examples. So here's these next two examples are going to be ones that you might come across on an AP exam if you're in an AP class. So we have our differential equation, and we're given an initial condition, and so we're expected to find the particular solution. So let's copy the problem down. Now let's get our dy's with the y's and the dx's with the x's. So if you multiply both sides by dx and divide both sides by y squared, you end up getting this. Now I might write the one on the left as just to make it easier and make it less likely for you to do the wrong antiderivative. I'd probably write it as y to the negative 2. That's to prevent some of you from thinking that any type of division has an antiderivative that's ln, which in this case it doesn't. So the antiderivative of both sides gives us the antiderivative of y to the negative 2. So again, add 1 to the exponent, and then you got to kill off the negative that would result if you took that derivative with a negative in front. And then the right side would be, x squared, and then I would need a 3 halves here, plus 3x, plus c. All right. Okay, so now we have a couple options. We can find c right now, or we can solve for y and then find c after. So that's just a preference that certain people have. I guess I'll find c now. So we know that when x is 0, y equals negative 1. So if I plug in negative 1 here, I get negative 1 to the negative 1, and that equals, the whole right side is going to become 0 except for the c. So negative 1 to the negative 1 is 1 over negative 1, which is negative 1, but then I'm taking the opposite of that, so that's a c, so that's a 1. So that's a lot of negatives there, but c is 1. So now I can continue solving this. And I've got that, I'm going to write now this as negative 1 over y instead of y to the negative y to the negative 1. That equals 3 halves x squared plus 3x plus 1. And now we're actually almost done. If I just cross multiply here, I get that negative 1 equal, and then, well, yeah, we'll cross multiply. And what I was going to say is you can kind of just switch the locations of the y in this 3x squared, 3 halves x squared plus 3x plus 1, but maybe just to be kind of consistent with how I've done it before, that times y, and then divide both sides by this term here. So that's correct. If you want to clear that fraction there at the bottom, you can multiply everything by 2, the top and the bottom. So you could even write it as negative 2 over 3x squared plus 6x plus 2. Either one. So these are both acceptable answers. All right, so there's just another example of solving a differential equation. I'll do one more on the next slide. All right, so we're doing another example. I guess the reason I included this one to distinguish it from the last one is because the separation of variables takes just an extra step here. So for instance, on the right-hand side, or on the previous example, the y's and the x's were already separated for us. Here we're going to have to do that on our own. So I think I'm going to factor out a 2x, and that leaves me with 3y plus 1. And now I can separate the variables. So if I divide both sides by 3y plus 1, multiply both sides by dx, I'm looking at this. So I take the antiderivative of both sides. The right side's easy, that's just x squared plus c. The left side, you gotta be careful. This is gonna be the natural log of the absolute value of 3y plus 1. Now, you may think you're done, but if you think about taking the derivative of ln of 3y plus 1, it would be 1 over 3y plus 1 times 3, but there is no 3 up here in the derivative, so that must mean I need to get rid of it with a 1/3 here. Okay. Again, here you can solve for c with the initial condition, or wait. Since I solved for c in the last example right away, I think I'm going to save it to the end this time just to give you some variety. What I will do though is multiply both sides by 3, so that way I can use the definition of ln. You can't do it with that 1/3 there. If you multiply by 3, you get 3x squared. This c can absorb that 3. You don't need to write 3c. This c is yet to be determined. It's just a constant. So multiplying an undetermined constant by 3 is just still an undetermined constant. So that's still a c. Now I can say e to the 3x squared plus c gives me this guy back. So that means that absolute value of 3y plus 1 is equal to e to the 3x squared plus c, which, note, is e to the 3x squared times e to the c. But e to the c, once again, is just another number. We might as well, it's all yet to be determined, so we might as well just give it a new name. So we'll call that e, or a, 3 to the x squared. And again, the absolute value of 3y plus 1 is going to be plus or minus a e to the 3x squared, but again, that a is yet to be determined, so I can just write this as so now we can solve for y. So this, if I subtract 1 and divide by 3, I've got that y equals a e 3x squared minus 1 divided by 3. All right, so there's the general solution. And if I wanted my particular solution, I would just plug in my initial condition. So y is 1 when a is 0, or when x is 0. So that's a e to the 0 minus 1 over 3. So that gives me a minus 1 over 3. So 1 equals a minus 1 over 3, which means that a minus 1 equals 3, which means that a equals 4. So my particular solution would be y equals 4. E to the 3x squared minus 1 divided by 3. All right, so there's two examples of ones that you would likely come across on an AP exam.